Hello friends, it's Prajal Pathak this side and you are watching my YouTube channel Pi Guru. Today in this tutorial we are going to learn about image color analysis with K-means Flash Print algorithm. Now I will be dividing this tutorial in three parts. So first of all we will be learning what is K-means Flash Print. Then we will learn what is K-means Flash Print algorithm. And then finally we will apply the K-means Flash Print algorithm to analyze colors in an image. So for this purpose, we'll be using two libraries, the scikit-learn and the OpenCV library. Okay. Also, by the end of this tutorial, you will be able to code this particular script which can analyze colors for us. So let's see what this script does. See here, I have two images, IMG1 and IMG2. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to apply the color analysis or K-means clustering on this particular image, and I'll be getting a pie chart which will tell me the top 5 colors which are available in greater amount in this particular image. So let it get executed. Actually my system is a little slow, so it will take a few seconds, but actually it's fast. So after it get done, we'll get a pie chart which will be saved in this particular folder. So let it get executed here. So this is the output that we got here. These are the top 5 colors which are dominated in the particular image. Also in the folder I will be getting an image which is something like this. So let it get opened. So see, these are the 5 images, 5 colors which are dominant in the particular image. So this will be the thing that we'll be doing by the end of this tutorial. So don't worry about the coding part, we'll be doing it from scratch and in the Jupyter notebook. Okay, so I'll be able to simply explain you all the code that I have written. Okay. So let's get started without wasting any time. So first of all, we'll be learning what is K-mean clustering. So K-mean clustering basically is a method to segregate data points in few clusters. For example, let me explain it to you by an analogy. If you go to a retail chain store or a shopping mall, you see number of different items are grouped together and kept at one place. For example, foods are kept at one place and vegetables are kept in one place. Okay, so this way fruits and vegetables are both segregated. Also in the fruits pane, you can see apples are kept at one place and oranges are kept at one place. So it's easier for the customer to choose whatever they want to buy. Okay. So this is K-mean clustering. Basically we keep one type of data points at one place and one type of data points at one place. We basically segregate data points based on certain similar characteristics. So this is the basic of K-mean clustering. Now let's see what is K-mean clustering algorithm. So I'll be explaining it to you by an example. So see here, I have few data points here, height and weight of few students. So you can see at height 185 centimeter, weight is 72 kgs. So there are several data points, and what you have to do, we have to put these data points in a cluster. So first of all, let's see what is the K-mean algorithm is. Basically in the K-mean clustering, the K stands for number of clusters in which you want to segregate your data point. Suppose I want to segregate these data points in two clusters. I want to group these data points in two groups. Okay, so let's see how can we do this. So the first thing is, in the K-mean algorithm, is we have to select K. So here K is 2, since we want to group the data points in two clusters. Okay, the next thing is we have to randomly choose K centroids here. So you can simply choose two centroids here. Why two? Because or the value of K is 2, we have to group the data points in two clusters. So you can simply choose any two data points. Here I will be choosing 185,72 as the first centroid and 170,56 as the second centroid. Centroid, you can say, is the center of a cluster. Okay, and this centroid will be keep changing by the throughout this algorithm. So let's see how the next step. The next step is, for the next element, which is this thing, we have to decide which cluster this will go into. Our first cluster is 185,72. And the second cluster is 170,56. So we have to decide in which cluster the next data point will go to, 168,60. So to decide, we have another formula, that is Euclidean distance formula. Basically what we will be doing here, we will be finding distance of this third point from the first cluster and the from second cluster. The formula for finding the distance is quite simple. It is a simple Euclidean distance formula, which is under root x0 minus x1 square plus y0 minus y1 square. Okay. Here an example 2. So first of all, let's try to find the distance of this third data point from the first cluster, which is 185, 72. So as a formula, distance from first cluster will be 185 minus 168, that is x0 will be this and 168 this. Okay, x0 and x1. You can reverse these two things and it will not matter, as we have a square here. So even if you get negative values, it will automatically get positive due to the square. Okay, so 185 minus 168 and 72 minus 60. So y0 minus y1 square. So 185 minus 168 is 17 and 72 minus 16 is 12. So 17 square plus 12 square. Okay, so if you apply root on it, we'll get this value 71.02. Next, we'll be finding the distance of this third data point from the second centroid, which is 178 minus 168 square plus 56 minus 60 square, which is 2 square plus 4 square, and then apply the under root. So 2 square plus 4 square, and we here get 4.47. Now see, the distance of third data point from first centroid is 71.02 and the unit, and 4.47 from the second centroid. This is the distance. So you can see the second data point is closer to the second centroid. So what we can do, we can simply put this second point data point in the second cluster. Okay, now here here our third step, third and fourth step will is cleared. Element will go to the nearest distance from the cluster. So the third point is nearest from the second cluster, so we'll just put it in the second cluster or second group. Now we have to recalculate centroid. See, as I said, the centroid will keep changing throughout the algorithm. So what we have to do, we have to recalculate the new centroid, as we have now two data points in the second centroid and first data one data point in the first centroid. So how to calculate recalculate centroid? It's simple formula. We have to simply find the average of it. So 170 plus 168 by 2, 56 plus 60 by 2. So if you have three elements, you have to find the average of all these three values. Okay, and then you will get the new centroid. Similarly, now you have to repeat the same process from here. Calculate from third step. So for fourth step two, you have to find the distance of first centroid and the distance of second centroid, which is the average of these two values. So you have to keep doing this until you reach to the end of the data point. So this is the basic of k-mean clustering, and if you solve it this algorithm to the end, you will find these two data points belong to one centroid and the first, and the rest data points belong to second centroid. Okay, so this is how you can do this algorithm. Now it's quite from scratch, but we do not have to do it like this. We already have algorithm which is k-means, which is already defined in the scikit-learn. So we do not have to do this thing from scratch. We can simply use the k-mean clustering algorithm from the scikit-learn. Now for this coding part, I'll move to my Jupyter notebook, so it will be easier for me to explain. Now you have to install few libraries before using this script, that are scikit-learn, matplotlib, OpenCV, and NumPy. You can simply install them like this. Pip install scikit-learn, matplotlib, OpenCV-python, and NumPy. So after installing, let's go to our Jupyter notebook. You have to import these modules from collections, import counter from sklearn. This is our scikit-learn dot cluster, import k-means. This is our algorithm. From matplotlib, import colors. From matplotlib.pyplot as plt, import numpy as np, and import cv2. Now this is a function which converts a RGB value to a hex value. Basically, let me just explain it, so I do not have to explain it in the later part. It's a function simply RGB to hex. It takes a tuple of three values, which can be RGB color. We know that RGB color are in R, G, B format, and R value can be from 0 to 55, same for G and B. So what you can do, it will just simply convert the RGB value to a hex value. Now hex value start from hash. So for example, if I have just to run this, let's see. I will be simply running this. Let me just execute this cell and also execute this cell, and then RGB to hex, I'll be converting the value of 255,0,0. So if I just run this, you will see I'll getting the hex value. Sorry, my fault, spelling mistake. RGB2hex. And here we have to pass the tuple. So this is the value, RGB value, hex value for red color. Now how this particular function works, basically it takes the tuple 255,0,0. 255 is the value of red, 0 is the value of green, and this 0 is the value of blue. It takes this tuple, creates a new string, empty string, hex color, and starts with a hash sign. Okay, we know that hex colors start with a hash sign. So now we are going to apply a for loop on this tuple 255,0,0. So for I in RGB color, I equals int I. If by chance this value is not in integer, we will convert it into integer. Now we will append the hex. First we will convert this integer value to a hex value and append it to the hex color string. So how to convert an integer into a hex value? It's very easy. You have to apply this thing :0 to x and :0 to x, and it will convert an integer value to a hex value, and now finally append it to the string. So this is how particularly this RGB2hex function works. So now let's get started with our color analysis part. So for this, we have to first load an image. So for this, I'll be using the first variable, that is img name. Here, see, I have few images, as you can see, img1.jpg and img2.jpg. Let me just delete this one that we just created. So for this particular one, I'll be using img1.jpg. So img1.jpg. Now we'll be loading this image to OpenCV. So raw img, this is my next variable, and this image will load the image in raw format. So cv2.imread, this is the method to load an image. So img name. The next thing is we are just going to convert this image from VGR to RGB. Now see, OpenCV reads an image in VGR format, which is blue, green, red format, instead of the common RGB format. So we have to convert it into back into RGB format. So it's very easy. cv2.cvtColor. This is another method to convert an image to RGB format. So cv2color. Here we, the first thing is the image, and the second thing is the format. So cv2.color and bgr to RGB. Okay. So what we have done, we have first created an img name variable and stored the name or the path of the image. So if you have image in some other folder, you have to pass the full path from here, copy path, and just paste it here. Okay. Now we have loaded the image into a raw image variable and then converted from VGR to RGB format. So let's just run this. So now we'll move to the next thing. We are just going to resize this image. So for this, I'll be creating a new variable img, and we'll be using the cv2.resize method. So again, it takes an image and then the width and new width and height. So I'll just pass 900,600, and here I'll be applying a simple interpolation. So interpolation will be cv2.interarea. Okay, cv2.interarea. This is an interpolation, you not have to understand, just write it like this. Okay. I'll explain it in detail in some other video. And finally, we are just going to receive this data point. Before that, let me just show you the img, apply this method img.save. Tuple object is, sorry, actually, I do not have to use this. So you can see our img shape is 600,900. So there are 600 rows and 900 columns. Okay. The next thing is, we are just going to give it to a new shape. So how can we do it? img will be img.resave. Now this is a part of pre-processing. We are just going it, doing it to pre-process the image or to get it ready for the k-means algorithm. Okay. So here I will be passing this img.save 0 multiplied by img.save 1 and then pass it 3 here. Again, if I just run img.save, cannot receive array of size 54,000 into 54 I have some error here. IMD.save 0 into IMD. So, wait a second. Okay, got it. Here is my error. Here I have to pass raw IMD. That's why I was getting the error. Okay, 600, 900, 3. And then if I just run this again. So our new shape is this 54544000. So we have converted into a 2D array now. Okay. You can also try printing IMG now, and you will see a two-dimensional array here. Okay, which is data point is a 8 in integer value. Okay. The next thing is we are just going to apply the k-means algorithm here. So how can you do it? So first of all, I'll be creating a variable called clf. Okay, and then I'll initialize the k-means. Here you have to pass the number of clusters, and which will be n clusters. So see, basically the output that we will get, the value that you will pass here will be the number of colors that you will get in the output. So if you pass 4 here, so you will get 4 prominent colors in the output. So I will simply pass 5 here. I want 5 dominant colors in the image. So I will simply pass n clusters equal 5. So our data point will be grouped into 5 clusters here. The next thing is color labels, and here we'll pass simply we have to fit the image. Now we have to pass the data point here. So fit clf dot fit predict, and here we have to pass our image, which is this thing clf dot fit predict, and we have to pass image here. The next thing is we can simply call we can find our center colors or centroid colors. You can see center colors equals clf dot color centers. Wait a minute, I am explaining you it to you. Clf dot center. Oops, sorry. Cluster centers. If I am right, let me just verify it here. If this is the thing, yes, cluster centers. So it's working fine. So let me just run this. We have an error here. N clusters. Again, spelling mistake. So now it will run. Basically here, what I am to do, I am just going to divide this 2D array like this one, and convert into group it into 5 clusters here. So in the end we'll be finding 5 dominant colors. Again we have another error, cluster centers. I guess again we have a spelling mistake here. So let me just copy this thing and paste it here. So if I just run this, now this will group our image data into 5 clusters. Okay, so let it get executed. It takes a few time now, and then I'll be able to explain you each line. Okay, so if I just simply print color labels, so you'll be able to see now their output. So you can see basically it's a one dimensional array which is simply consists of 1 1 1 1 1 1, something like this. But basically what this one means, the first color belongs to the group 1, the second color belongs to group 1, third color belongs to group 1, and there are 5 values inside this array. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 4, 5 values inside this array, which means what color belongs to which group. Okay, so you can see these 3, these 6 visible colors belong to group 1. So there are few more colors inside this hidden, this dot 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 ellipses we say. So these belong to 2, 3, 4, 5. Colors, you can say clusters. Okay, also you can try printing center colors. So let's just try printing it. So you can see these are the 5 centroids or the 5 colors that we will get in the end. So 119 119 119, this is the RGB value for the first centroid, RGB value for the second centroid, RGB value for the third centroid, and this and this. Okay, so you can see simply here what RGB, all values are nearly same in each colors. Okay, so these are the 5 colors that we have got from this algorithm, 5 centroids that we have got from this algorithm. So now what we can do, we can simply try finding how many colors belong to each center. Now see, we have imported the counter from collection. So from collection import counter. Now here we can just simply pass our color labels. Okay, now it will tell us how many elements belong to the cluster 1, how many elements belong to cluster 2, something like this. Okay, if I just run this and print counts here, it will give me the frequency of each color. So see, in the first cluster we have these much elements, in the third cluster we have these much elements, in the fourth cluster this much element, zero cluster this much element, and second cluster this much element. So the most important color in this cluster is this particular value, the cluster 1 or the group 1. So now let's try putting, converting it into a hex value, so we'll be able to read this in a colored format. Okay, so for this already we have defined the RGB value. So here, since we are getting the float value, but this will convert it to an integer. We have already applied the integer value. Okay, so ordered colors equals center colors I for I in count dot keys. See here, count over is a special type of dictionary, which is counter dictionary, which simply stores the frequency of each group here. The next thing is we have tried converting it into an ordered color list, and then we are simply pass it to a hex colors. Let's create a new list, and here what I'll be doing, I'll be creating passing this each value to RGB to hex function. Okay, I for I in count dot keys. Here instead of I we have to pass ordered colors here, so let me just copy it and paste it here. So ith index. So if I just try printing now, you will see each colors will be converted into a again here is I have an error, counts, this will be counts and this will be counts. So much error today in this tutorial. Okay, so these are the 5 prominent colors inside our image. Okay, so basically what we did, we just extracted all the colors and stored in them ordered colors list, and then we converted each value RGB value to hex and stored it into a hex colors list. Now finally what we can do, we can simply pass it to a plot. We can simply plot it. So plt.figure, this is my figure size, and here I can pass fig size equals 12,8. 12 will be 8 width and 8 will be height. And the next is we are going to plot a pie chart in it. So its value will be counts dot values, and then the next thing will be labels will be hex colors. Now see, this will be our label too. Okay, these 5 values, and the next thing colors, we have to pass colors here again, this will be hex colors. Here instead of x will be c, will be having c here. The next thing is we can simply save it, plt.savefig, something like this. We have to pass name here, already see here we have stored the name of the image in the img name variable, so I'll simply be using it. So here I'll simply pass img name and slash it to the -4th index. Here we have to use colon. So what we'll do, it will remove .jpg part or .png or .eif part from it, and simply put the name of the image, and then analysis .png. I want to save my image by this name. Okay, if I just run this, you will see I'll be getting a pie chart here. So see here, we are successfully getting the pie chart here. So this is how the whole thing works here. Now what I'm going to do, I'll be running this. This is the whole script. Okay, I hope you explained. If you have some doubt, you can ask it in the comment section. Now I'll simply apply this whole in a one form into this script, and let's just run this, and you will see after this script is completed, see here, this is our actual pie chart. Okay, so what was here actually, it was showing the image for RGB format, VGA format images. Okay, that's why it wasn't able to do it, but this one is the actual thing that we have got. Okay, so yep, this is how you can analyze colors or top 5 colors in an image. You can pass the value of k equals 6 and you will get 6 most prominent colors in the image. You can pass 2 to get 2 most prominent colors in the image, something like this. Okay, so this is how you can apply color analysis which came in ClusterScreen. So I hope you understood this video. If you have any doubt, you can ask it in the comment section. If you love this video, leave a like or a dislike. If you are new to my channel, subscribe it. Thank you. See you in the next tutorial.